गुड आफ्टरनून मैम। गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन।
गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
ओके सो शैल वी स्टार्ट आवर लेसन टुडे?
यस मैम।
ओके यस्टरडे वी हैव लास्ट क्लास वी लर्न अबाउट फिजिकल एंड केमिकल चेंजेस। ओके सो अबा व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय फिजिकल चेंजेस अबा?
मैम सब्सटेंस व्हिच नॉन न्यू सब्सटेंस आर फॉर्म।
सब्सटेंसेस व्हिच
मैम चेंज इन नॉन न्यू सब्सटेंस।
नॉन न्यू सब्सटेंस। ओके वृषा व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय केमिकल चेंज? वृषा
केमिकल चेंज इज द चेंज इन व्हिच वन और मोर सब्सटेंसेस न्यू सब्सटेंसेस आर फॉर्मड।
ओके यस फिदर कैन यू गिव मी टू प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ अ फिजिकल चेंज?
यस मैम। मैम फिजिकल चेंज इज अ चेंज इन व्हिच नो सब्सटेंसेस आर इज फॉर्मड।
Okay.
Ma'am, in a physical change, the physical properties like shape, size, age, etc. of the substance changes. Ma'am, example, cutting of paper into pieces, okay. melting of ice, okay. boiling of water, okay. stretching a rubber band, etc. Some
okay.
physical changes are reversible. Melting of ice, boiling of water, stretching a rubber band, etc.
Okay, okay. Okay, can you tell me another type of change?
A chemical change.
Another type of a property apart in the physical change?
Instead of reversible change.
Reversible
change. Irreversible
okay.
change.
Okay, okay, fine. Okay, Geetika, tell me the properties of chemical changes.
Properties of one or more new substances are formed. Heat or light may be absorbed or released.
Okay. One or more new substance are formed or released. And what else? What else?
The changes are irreversible.
Okay. It is reversible. And there are nearly five changes,
yes,
correct?
Ma'am.
Okay. So iron. Okay. Enough. Iron, can you tell me again the chemical change?
And the properties.
Properties of chemical changes.
And also known as chemical reaction. During a chemical change, these following changes take place. Formation of new substances.
Ayan, can you say without telling that?
Heat or light is released or absorbed.
Heat or light is released or absorbed. Okay.
New gases are formed. And can you hear me?
Ma'am? Okay, Ayan. So children, we have studied this many processes and the changes, the properties of chemical changes as well as the physical changes. And now we are going to see some of the processes involved in chemical reaction. Some of the process which is involved in chemical reaction, we are going to see the first process. Now you can write down. You can write the heading.
Ma'am, we already wrote it.
You are not written, no?
For yes,
processes involved in chemical reaction. Did you write about fermentation and all?
We write the differentiated.
Ah, difference only, no? Okay. Fine. So next thing we are moving on to, you can write processes involved in chemical reaction means it is also is a chemical change. Another name of, it's not a page number because in our textbook these activities are given. So this is chapter 6. Page number 59. Okay. So the first one, we are moving on to fermentation. Fermentation means we are mixing two chemical substances and you're keeping for some time. After some time, it will be turned into a new substance. Can you guess what are the things we do in our daily life fermenting something?
And pickles.
Pickle is one fermentation. Okay. Joining and mixing together. And what and about fish. The fish.
And fish?
Okay, fish we put the tamarind on something, we keep it. Anything else? Breakfast and all, you used to have some common food. What is that?
Ma'am, tea.
And dosa.
Dosa. Okay, fermentation. It's an example that making dosa and idli flour. Or you can also say making appam. Correct. So making dosa flour.
Let me eat.
We are putting yeast and making appam flour, correct? So this is an example of fermentation. I'm like giving one example, but we can see so many process in fermentation that is about make pickle preservation, or we also make the non-veg and fish items. You can keep it for a long time after drying or after making into pickle or putting salt and some tamarind into it, and it will remain 2-3 days without spoiling. So all this we do before we get to fridge. Okay, before we get fridge, we used to do this kind of traditional way of fermentation. Okay, keeping the mangoes, small mangoes in the salt water. Yeah, all these things are part of fermentation. That is
gooseberries also.
Yeah, gooseberries. That means after keeping it for some time, it turns into a new substance. That is known as fermentation. So this is also is a chemical change. The second one is rusting of iron. So rusting of iron, we are going to learn detail. This is something that is iron materials turn into useless object. Rusting of iron is mainly based on rusting. The process only mainly based on the iron material. We don't call any other things rusting. So rusting is only related to iron. Okay, so iron is turning into irumbu thurumba nu arayile. Once it become into rusted form, then naturally that iron material is going to be useless. You can only sell it. Okay, now third one we are moving on to is explosion. Explosion means some of the chemical reactions when undergo, the sound will be heard. So another one example is bomb explosion. Bomb explosion is an example of a chemical reaction which happens due to exploding. Bomb explosion. Then reaction between acid and base. Sometimes the strong acid and strong base.
Neutralization.
Yeah. Now neutralization is not an explosion. It is, I am telling, the reaction with strong base and strong acid. That means sometimes this can be, once this reaction take place, there will be sound is produced. Acid and base reacted, then that can be even make the bottle to break into pieces. if we are not careful of mixing strong acid and strong, the neutralization is something different. Once you do the neutralization, they both become neutral. There is no power for acid or base. That is neutralization. It is also is a chemical reaction. That's true, but that is not belong to explosion.
Can you explain fermentation one more time?
Fermentation means we are mixing two different substances and keeping for some time, and that mixture will be turned into a new substance. That is fermentation. You can only learn the example. No need of writing the definition of all this process. Try to understand which are these all included in chemical changes. Now, next one, we are moving on to corrosion, oxidizing or oxidation. That is also is a chemical reaction. Oxidation, we are not learning in the small classes. We will be learning in 10th standard. Oxidation or oxidizing. This is two chemical substances react to form new compound. Example we have in our textbook, that is burning of magnesium. The burning of magnesium is the example for oxidation. That is when magnesium burns, it will turn into a new compound, magnesium oxide. So that is the oxidation or oxidizing. You are getting a totally new compound that will be chemical.
Yes, ma'am, it is a chemical.
Yes. Fermentation and all we are using in our daily life, but this chemical reaction we are not using in our daily life, but it is using for industrial purposes. Actually, industrial purposes. Studio not working. Okay, now the fifth one, the next one, corrosion means the destruction of metallic objects. It can be aluminium, it can be a copper, it can be any metallic object.
What is the meaning of destruction?
Which destruction means it is losing its all properties. That is aluminium vessel. Suppose you are using an aluminium vessel for cooking something. Suppose you are keeping aluminium vessel, and inside aluminium you are keeping tamarind for a long time. Naturally, after some time, you will able to see aluminium vessel will have some black color, and also there will be some holes on it. Okay, so this is means corrosion. Actually, in chemistry, we can call it up. Metals are eaten up. Metals are eaten up by something. So there is a chemical reaction taking place between the acid present in the tamarind and the aluminium. So that reaction will make the aluminium vessels to become a useless thing. So whenever we cook fish curry, like any curry which has lot of tamarind, we don't keep that kind of food in the aluminium vessels for a long time, because it will react with the aluminium. One day, two day, if you keep, it's okay. But if you are going to preserve it, even curd, it is not good to keep in aluminium vessel. Curd will get spoiled if you keep in aluminium vessel. Similarly, usually we don't preserve tamarind in the aluminium vessel, because aluminium vessels will corrode. Corrode means it will lose its property. Aluminium lose its property and we cannot be used. So that is known as corrosion. Sometime you will able to see the bridges, the pillars of the bridges are corroding away due to continuous chemical reaction or between. Okay, so another way is eaten up, we call it. It is eaten up with some chemical reaction. Now sixth one is tarnishing. Tarnishing means metallic objects are losing its color. Tarnishing means metallic objects losing its color. Example, silver ornaments turn into black in color. You must have seen whenever you wear silver anklets and all, after some time it will be turned into dark color. So that is known as tarnishing.
Silver, can we also call it as galvanization?
Galvanization is something different. Okay.
This is
the nature. Silver ornaments losing its color. Sometimes even our gold ornaments, you can see when you buy, it was shining like anything. After some time you wear it continuously, you can see the gold color is turning into little more dark because it is tarnished with the dust particles and other particles which is present in air. And if you wash this, it will go out. Okay, usually.
Can see the dress in the waiting room.
Yeah, I have admitted.
Okay.
Tarnishing, that is what you call for tarnishing. And you can see that nilavilakku, what we use in temples. Yeah. So you see, if you don't clean that lamp every day, what will happen to that vilakku? It will be turning to
black
in color. It will be dark. Then we have to apply the tamarind and something here to make it little shining later. So every day, if you don't clean that lamp which is lighted in the temples, after some time it will turn into dark or black in color. Sometimes it will also produce some greenish color fungus on it. So that is known as tarnishing. But tarnishing is not temporary, is not permanent. If you wash it, this color can return. But like corrosion and all, once it happened, nothing can be changed. Tarnishing is sometimes by using some chemical materials and you can regain its color because only color change. The material has no problem with it. The next one is burning. That is already we know, burning the paper. Okay, so burning is actually fireworks, lighting candle, all these are examples. All this, so burning also is a chemical process. Then eighth one, the last one we are having is rotting. That's very simple, spoiling of the vegetables.
I'm like apple.
Apple and not only apple, any vegetable you keep it, you see.
Okay.
Even in the fridge also, some water get into it. The all vegetables what you preserved in the fridge also gets spoiled. So rotting means spoiling vegetables, and also even when the person die and all, you see within 2 days, if you don't bury and you don't burn it, the person body started rotting. You will get a bad smell out of it. So spoiling vegetables, food items, etc. Okay, so this is also is a processes involved chemical reaction. And apart from this, we are having other two, one, galvanization and crystallization. The next one.
It is also
a chemical reaction. Galvanization also is a chemical process. That is coating iron. Iron with zinc, chromium, chromium, gallium, etc. Gallium, etc. To save to preserve from getting rust. To preserve from rusting. Yeah.
And can you say what
is that coating? Means you can prevent the rusting cavernous. Coating means painting. Okay. Take the iron rod and you can just paint it. Paint it with the zinc. But it's not simply painting. What we do means, you know why we make gold ornaments? Gold, rolled gold ornaments. They are not pure gold. But what we do, we can make an ornament out of copper and we can do the electroplating to look like a gold. So that is what galvanization. It's not just simply painting.
Okay.
Galvanization means we will melt the zinc metal. Suppose you want to coat the iron rod like bridges, and you see some of the cyber companies, the Technopark and all those things, all their buildings are fully glass case, and the glass houses naturally we need a aluminium or silver color bar to attach. So that silver color is made due to the process of galvanization on iron materials. So it is an industrial process, big process. They will melt the zinc in a huge furnace, and afterwards they will dip the big iron sheets in the silver coating. They dip it in the high temperature, and afterwards what they do, they will take it and make it cool after dipping into the melted zinc fluid at a high temperature. They'll dip that iron sheets in the cold water. By dipping into the cold water, this zinc coating will become fixed on it. So this is a industrial purpose. Galvanization is not the one we can do at home. This is a industrial purposes. Okay.
Ma'am, you said that you will discuss the exercise questions of transportation.
Yes. So this is about the galvanization. And there is the last process involved in this is crystallization. So that means all these are various processes involved in chemical changes. Crystallization. Crystallization means some of the water droplets. So we can say formation of diamond. Formation of diamond, ruby, all these precious stones, ruby. Okay.
And salt.
Yes. 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 Then we are having some of the, so there are seven type of different stones are there, no? Not only diamond, we also have a garnet. We are having garnet.
Gemstone.
Gems.
Sapphire.
Emerald.
Topaz.
Yeah. So all this seven precious. I think it is seven.
Diamond.
Topaz also.
So sometimes we the formation of the pearls. Pearls also is due to the crystallization of the water droplets in the seabed. So the formation of a diamond, ruby, salt, sapphire, pearls, all the precious stones, the costly stones, we are having crystallization of the some of the chemical substances. Actually, diamond is the hard chemical substances in the world. It is very hard, very difficult to cut into small pieces. And diamond, that's a diamond also, or diamond ornaments are very costly. Even the smallest diamond, we have to you have to pay lakhs and all.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Yeah. So why? Because the formation of the diamond is not so easy. Formation of the diamond is a natural diamond formation. Due to the reaction between carbon, oxygen, hydrogen, all this will be mixed together, and it will be in the molten, it will be in the fluid state first, and due to fermentation underground of earth. Fermentation means it doesn't have presence of air. So diamond is formed in the mines underground, and it's a tedious process. We cannot make artificially diamond. It's a natural source, so that is why it is very costly. So just like gold, we have to mine the diamond in some of the places. Okay, so that's about. So these are the various chemical processes involved in chemical changes. So the, all these things we will be learning in higher classes in much detail. Here we are only learning what is the example or how or each one of these processes are involved. Okay. Yes, Friza, are you saying something?
Ma'am, the slide.
Ah, slide. There is time, Friza. Okay, I cannot come to that first to complete the portion. Correct.
Can I ask a doubt?
Yes.
Now, even though we do galvanization, still it will rust, right?
No, it is less.
Okay.
But it can be possible as years goes by. Okay. But you see, iron and all, no need of years. One day, 2 day enough. One day, 2 day, you put the iron in the rainwater. After some time, you can see it starts.
And rainwater or dump air?
Not only rainwater. You just keep the safety pin inside the cupboard. After 1 week, you see sometimes the safety pin also turn into years. So it doesn't take much time. Yeah, because the rusting will be will happen only then there is a moisture in the air. Okay, sometimes you close the cupboard and keep. That's why chemical, why does it get, that's a chemical reaction happens. The water has hydrogen and oxygen, so it will react with the iron, then undergo chemical reaction. Okay, now shall we go to page number 131, all of you? Shall we complete the exercise questions of previous chapter, because you are having a test coming on Monday, written test. Have you done it? I told you to do it as a homework. You wait till 2022. Okay. That time the next chapter I have to take test. Respiration I have not taken test. So transportation we will do, because that is we completed recently. So that heart and all we remain fresh in your mind. So afterwards, once the reopen comes, respiration chapter is going to have a written test. Okay, shall we go to the next person? Abhyuday, have you done the exercise? Question number one.
Yeah, I have done.
You have done. Okay, those who do not know, we can do now. Abhyuday, can you read the question number one? Everyone check in your textbook. Exercise one. Match structures given in column one with the functions given in column two. Abhyuday, the first one, stomata. Which is
the correct? Can I say?
Abhyuday, you try. You have the textbook with you. Do you have? I think he is having network issue. Okay, fine. Sri Lakshmi, tell me, stomata.
Transpiration,
correct. Xylem, Steve, xylem, which is the correct one?
Ma'am, transport of water.
Transport of water, okay. Francis Richard, root hairs, which is the correct one?
Francis,
you have the textbook, Francis. Okay, shall I move to Anna? Root hairs.
Ma'am, absorption of water.
Absorption of water, okay. Hiba Fatima, phloem. Which is the correct one, phloem? No.
Can I tell?
Hiba, did you hear what I asked?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Hiba. Okay, unmute and tell me that match ma'am, the following last one. Phloem, correct answer.
Ma'am, can I tell ma'am?
Don't know. Okay, fine. So she is just searching in the book. Okay, Francis, did you know phloem?
Ma'am, phloem.
Transport of?
Transport of food.
Did you say that, Francis?
Francis said, but it is something to be sure.
Okay, okay. Transport of food. Correct. Once again, I read stomata, transpiration, phylum, transport of water, root hairs, absorption of water, and phloem, transport of food. Did you get that? Okay, fine. So next is Amida. Can you hear me, Amida? No.
Yes, ma'am.
Ah, okay, Amida, can you give me the answer first to fill in the blanks? Can you read the question?
The blood from the heart is transferred to all the parts of the body by the?
By the what? All parts, who carries, arteries or veins? Amita?
Arteries.
Arteries. A-R-T-E-R-I-E-S. Arteries. Okay. Harriet, next one. Can you read?
Which question?
Can I?
Question number two. Fill in the blanks. Hemoglobin, that one, read.
Okay.
Question number two in fill in the blanks. Harriet? No reading. I can't hear
ma'am,
you,
she
Harriet.
She has some network issues.
Okay, so Anthony Vichaw, can you hear me? See, so many are switching off. Okay, Ismail Suhin, you tell me. Hemoglobin, second question. What's the correct one? Suhim. Smile, Suhim. Hemoglobin is?
Ma'am.
Present in what cells, Ismail? Don't know. Okay.
Ma'am,
see,
ma'am red blood cells, ma'am.
Red
ma'am,
blood
red
cells.
Red blood cells.
Red blood cells. Okay, Anthony. Red blood cells. Or we can write RBC. Okay, red blood cells. Yes, next one, Risa, third one.
Arteries and veins are joined by the network of...
What is that? What's that, Risa? Your audio is breaking. Can you switch off the video and answer me?
No, she is saying something.
Is it capillaries you said? Because her voice is broken. Is it capillaries, Risa?
Ma'am, capillaries.
Yes, capillaries. Correct. All of you, please write capillaries. C A P I L L A R I E S. Capillaries. Okay, now the first one. So fill in the blanks. So those who don't know the spelling, first one we have RBC or red blood cells. Second one, we are having arteries.
Ma'am, first one is
first one is artery. Okay.
Ma'am, first one is artery.
Red blood cells.
Okay. Arteries. Second one is RBC. And third one is capillaries.
Capillaries.
Okay. Next one. Shall we go to Fidel? Next one.
Ma'am, the rhythmic expansion and contraction of the heart is called heartbeat.
Okay. So, fourth one is heartbeat.
Heartbeat, ma'am.
Aldous, next one. What
yes,
is next?
Ma'am. Ma'am, the main... ma'am, this is pondering. The main excretory product in human beings is urine.
What did you say?
Mom, the main excretory system in human beings.
Is?
I mean product.
is
urine.
Urea, not urine, urea. Okay, urine is a liquid content. Okay, the main majority major product is urea. Okay, Aldous, not urine, urea. Okay, urea is the major waste product. The question is, EU, I think E is silent, no? Yes, the, yeah, I remember I taught you urea only. Urine also is there, but the major product is urea.
Urea spelling,
there's no E.
Some place urea, you can write it. Okay. Some books I have seen the silent. I don't know where it is. Okay,
mom,
fine.
Like, there is like, mom, usually in British and American English, S and Z, same like that.
Yeah, that's what I got confused. I have wrote E, but some of the books it is written E U R E E A. That's why I have written like
mom,
that.
Here it is U R E A.
Yeah. Mom, so in the book it is Uria. Okay. Shall we go to the next one?
Yes, ma'am.
Pet contains water and what? Something else.
Salt.
Ma'am, salt.
Salt. Okay. Salt. The sixth one is almost timer. Sixth one is salt. Okay. Now,
Amina.
Yes, next one say.
Ma'am, next one is urine.
Eliminate
the waste materials in the liquid form called urine.
That is urine. Okay, U-R-I-I-N. The main excretive product is urea. The liquid waste is urine. Okay. Eighth one.
Water reaches great heights in the trees because of suction caused by transpiration.
So the transpiration is the process that the water has been absorb. It reaches to the leaves and then it has been be absorbed. So that's the process we call transpiration. Next one, question number 3. We complete it. Choose the correct option.
Mom, I completed, ma'am.
Yeah.
Steven, I also completed, ma'am.
Adul Krishna, what is the correct answer? Question number 3. Choose the correct option.
Xylem.
Xylem. Yes, you can tick on xylem. And B. Yes.
The water absorption through roots can be increased by keeping the plants under the fan.
Under the fan, no. Covered with the polythene bag.
Yes,
okay.
Ma'am.
Not the fan. Can we put the, for the plants fan?
No,
okay.
Ma'am.
Sorry, ma'am.
Then leaves all will be
fed. It was by mistake. Sorry.
Okay. It's okay. Covered with the polythene bag. Yes. Okay. Okay, children. So I wind up the session. So the remaining portion of the physical change we will be discussing in the next class. 1 minute. Okay. Let me take today. So many are present as we compare to other classes.